Alright, so we're going to be making a retaining wall using interlocking brick stones. It's going to go all alongside here to probably 9 or 10 feet away from the brick house. And right to the stake is going to be the face of it. All along here, right to about underneath the tree. So we got a lot of excavating to do of all this topsoil. Bell phone line, and years ago it was hit, so we were told about it. We knew where it was, we knew not to hit it. It had been spliced a long time ago and it's held up for years and years and years, so we're spending some extra time, extra care around this so we don't have to damage it again. Okay, so we got a really good start to this. It's coming along really nice. Just about lunchtime now, so we'll go and unload this. This is when a dump trailer would come in really handy, but all my friends with dump trailers are being used right now, so we'll have to hand bomb it off or be creative in getting it off. Alright, we gotta unload here at the gravel pit, and we kinda got a little bit buried, backed up a little bit too far, a little too soft. Now we're stuck, so we'll have to hand bomb all this crap off and then try to push our way out using the deck and stinger and whatnot. At the end of day two, got the base all prepped, ready, it's level. Got some of this dirt moved away. And we're gonna step it down two at a time over here. Got the gravel in behind all packed down and folded over. Now we're just about ready for the coping to go in behind. I just wanted to go over a couple things with the coping. Now this is the top one. The reason I cut this is so I can have a gravelly or a rough cut finish on the end corner pieces as well. So this piece that I just cut out here, I put an exact template there and make a cut, and then the idea is that piece is going to go right in there, so you have a rough surface here and a rough surface here, so it looks good on the ends. and just about finished here.